Used in everything from cereal to sweeteners to the ethanol and gasoline. But tonight, local farmers say they are in a corn crop crisis. The Department of Agriculture is reporting the crops are in their worst condition right now since 1988.
Wow, and it's happening just as farmers' crops enter their peak development stage. 11 News reporter Rob Roblin has the details new at 5:30.
In a normal year, this corn would be about eye level to me. You can see what the extreme heat has done to this crop.
The leaves are burned, literally scorched from the sun. But this plant we're irrigating the sweet corn, and it's going to actually try to produce a little ear. What it's going to be capable of doing, I don't know.
Bob Baer farms 107 acres here in Queen Anne's County on the Eastern Shore. He grows vegetables and lots of corn. The extreme heat we've had has taken its toll on Bob's corn crop.
These ears should be positioned about this high. This plant had compacted itself, and it's going to try to produce two ears. At this point, it says, I can do this. But like I say, these ears should be up here.
Bob's not the only farmer in Maryland whose crop has been damaged by the heat.
And all the corn and soybeans grown here on Delmarva feed the poultry industry. So because of the poultry industry that we have here, they're going to have to pay higher prices for corn because not only there's a drought here, but there's a drought in the Midwest.
According to the Maryland Agriculture Department, the triple-digit temperatures with no precipitation has stressed corn and soybeans. 23% of the corn and soybean crops statewide are in poor or very poor condition. Jenny Rhodes is the Queen Anne's County Ag Agent.
When it gets 100 degrees or above, it kills the pollen. So you're killing that pollen, and then you'll have an ear with no kernels on it. So that's what we may see. You may see driving down the road, you may think, oh, wow, that corn field looks really nice. But in the end, these 100-degree days could have killed that pollen that, you know, that makes that ear, that makes those kernels.
The good news, though, thanks to irrigation, there's still lots of good Maryland vegetables and tomatoes.
Most all the produce is in good condition, even with the conditions.
Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV, 11 News.